the Gospel of John, coloring Bible in English, verse by verse from chapters 20 to 21, plus the first four chapters of the book of the Acts of the Apostles. The empty tomb, the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verse 1 to 11. Background: Jesus was taken down from the cross on Good Friday afternoon and laid inside a garden tomb. Pilate ordered his guards to close the tomb and to keep everyone away from the body of Jesus. It was a sad Good Friday. Until Easter Sunday morning. Now on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene went early, while it was still dark, to the tomb. And she saw the stone taken away from the tomb. Therefore she ran and came to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken away the Lord out of the tomb, and we don't know where they have laid him." Therefore Peter and the other disciple went out, and they went toward the tomb. They both ran together. The other disciple outran Peter and came to the tomb first, stooping and looking in. He saw the linen cloths lying, yet he didn't enter in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and entered into the tomb. He saw the linen cloths lying, and the cloth that had been on his head, not lying with the linen cloths, but rolled up in a place by itself. So then the other disciple, who came first to the tomb, also entered in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they didn't know the scripture that he must rise from the dead. So the disciples went away again to their own homes. But Mary was standing outside at the tomb, weeping. Think about it. Talk about it. Mary Magdalene is crying because her hope has died. What could you tell a friend who thinks they have no hope? He is risen. John chapter 20, starting at verse 12. Background: Mary Magdalene returns to the empty tomb to see two angels waiting for her. She is still very upset that Jesus is gone. So as she wept, she stooped and looked into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting, one at the head and one at the feet, where the body of Jesus had lain. They asked her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "Because they have taken away my Lord, and I don't know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing, and didn't know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Who are you looking for?" She, supposing him to be the gardener, said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him, "Rabboni," which is to say, "Teacher." Jesus said to her, "Don't hold me, for I haven't yet ascended to my Father. But go to my brothers and tell them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene came and told the disciples that she had seen the Lord and that he had said these things to her. When therefore it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and when the doors were locked where the disciples were assembled for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in the middle and said to them, "Peace be to you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples therefore were glad when they saw the Lord. Jesus therefore said to them again, "Peace be to you. As the Father has sent me, even so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive anyone's sins, they have been forgiven them. If you retain anyone's sins, they have been retained." Think about it. Talk about it. Jesus sent his disciples out to tell the world about him. Have you ever told anyone about your faith in Jesus? What happened? Doubting Thomas, John 20, from verse 24 to chapter 21, verse 12. Background. Thomas had watched his Lord and friend Jesus die on a cross only 10 days earlier. He got upset when he heard everyone say that Jesus was alive again. Until... But Thomas, one of the 12, called Didymus, wasn't with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see in his hands the print of the nails, put my finger into the print of the nails, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." After 8 days, again his disciples were inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, the doors being locked, and stood in the middle and said, "Peace be to you." Then he said to Thomas, "Reach here your finger and see my hands. Reach here your hand and put it into my side. Don't be unbelieving, but believing." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Therefore Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing you may have life in his name. After these things, Jesus revealed himself again to the disciples at the Sea of Tiberias. He revealed himself this way. Simon Peter, Thomas called Didymus, Nathanael of Cana in Galilee, and the sons of Zebedee, and two others of his disciples were together. Simon Peter said to them, "I'm going fishing." They told him, "We are also coming with you." They immediately went out and entered into the boat. That night, they caught nothing. But when day had already come, Jesus stood on the beach. Yet the disciples didn't know that it was Jesus. Jesus therefore said to them, "Children, have you anything to eat?" They answered him, "No." He said to them, "Cast the net on the right side of the boat, and you will find some." They cast it, therefore, and now they weren't able to draw it in for the multitude of fish. That disciple, therefore, whom Jesus loved, said to Peter, "It's the Lord." So when Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he wrapped his coat around himself, for he was naked, and threw himself into the sea. But the other disciples came in the little boat, for they were not far from the land, but about 200 cubits away, dragging the net full of fish. So when they got out on the land, they saw a fire of coals there, with fish and bread laid on it. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish which you have just caught." Simon Peter went up and drew the net to land, full of 153 great fish. Even though there were so many, the net wasn't torn. Jesus said to them, "Come and eat breakfast." Think about it. Thomas refused to believe that Jesus was alive unless he could see him and touch him. Do you believe in Jesus? Pause this movie and tell us how your faith got started. Do you love me? Finishing up the last chapter of the Gospel of John. Background. Peter had denied Jesus 3 times on the night that Jesus was arrested. So now, Jesus asks Peter 3 times in front of everyone, "Peter, do you love me?" None of the disciples dared inquire of him, "Who are you?" knowing that it was the Lord. Then Jesus came and took the bread, gave it to them, and the fish likewise. This is now the third time that Jesus was revealed to his disciples after he had risen from the dead. So when they had eaten their breakfast, Jesus said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of Jonah, do you love me more than these?" He said to him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I have affection for you." He said to him, "Feed my lambs." He said to him again a second time, "Simon, son of Jonah, do you love me?" He said to him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I have affection for you." He said to him, "Tend my sheep." He said to him the third time, "Simon, son of Jonah, do you have affection for me?" Peter was grieved because he asked him the third time, "Do you have affection for me?" He said to him, "Lord, you know everything. You know that I have affection for you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep. Most certainly, I tell you, when you were young, you dressed yourself and walked where you wanted to. But when you are old, you will stretch out your hands, and another will dress you and carry you where you don't want to go." Now he said this, signifying by what kind of death he would glorify God. When he had said this, he said to him, "Follow me." Then Peter, turning around, saw a disciple following. This was the disciple whom Jesus loved, the one who had also leaned on Jesus' breast at the supper and asked, "Lord, who is going to betray you?" Peter, seeing him, said to Jesus, "Lord, what about this man?" Jesus said to him, "If I desire that he stay until I come, what is that to you? You follow me." This saying therefore went out amongst the brothers, that this disciple wouldn't die. Yet Jesus didn't say to him that he wouldn't die, but, "If I desire that he stay until I come, what is that to you?" This is the disciple who testifies about these things and wrote these things. We know that his witness is true. There are also many other things which Jesus did, which if they would all be written, I suppose that even the world itself wouldn't have room for the books that would be written. Think about it. Talk about it. Who do you know that really, really loves Jesus? How do you know they love him? How can you tell? The Gospel of John ends. The Book of Acts starts. Up, up, and away. The Book of Acts, chapter 1, verses 1 to 26. Background. Jesus has been with his family and his closest followers for 40 days after he rose from the dead. Now it's time for him to leave. Now, what do we do? The first book I wrote, Theophilus, concerned all that Jesus began both to do and to teach until the day in which he was received up, after he had given commandment through the Holy Spirit, to the apostles whom he had chosen. To these he also showed himself alive, after he suffered, by many proofs appearing to them over a period of 40 days, and speaking about God's kingdom. Being assembled together with them, he commanded them, "Don't depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which you heard from me. For John indeed baptized in water, but you will be baptized in the Holy Spirit not many days from now." Therefore, when they had come together, they asked him, "Lord, are you now restoring the kingdom to Israel?" He said to them, "It isn't for you to know times or seasons, which the Father has set within his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. You will be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the uttermost parts of the earth." When he had said these things, as they were looking, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. While they were looking steadfastly into the sky, as he went, behold, two men stood by them in white clothing. who also said, "You men of Galilee, why do you stand looking into the sky? This Jesus, who was received up from you into the sky, will come back in the same way as you saw him going into the sky." Then they returned to Jerusalem from the mountain called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they had come in, they went up into the upper room where they were staying. That is Peter, John, James, Andrew, Philip, Thomas, Bartholomew, Matthew, James the son of Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas the son of James. All these with one accord continued steadfastly in prayer and supplication, along with the women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brothers. In these days, Peter stood up in the middle of the disciples, and the number of names was about 120, and said, "Brothers, it was necessary that this scripture should be fulfilled, which the Holy Spirit spoke before, by the mouth of David concerning Judas, who was guide to those who took Jesus. For he was counted with us, and received his portion in this ministry. Now this man obtained a field with the reward for his wickedness, and falling headlong, his body burst open, and all his intestines gushed out. It became known to everyone who lived in Jerusalem that in their language, that field was called Akeldama, that is, the field of blood. For it is written in the book of Psalms, 'Let his habitation be made desolate, let no one dwell in it, and let another take his office.' Of the men, therefore, who have accompanied us all the time that the Lord Jesus went in and out amongst us, beginning from the baptism of John to the day that he was received up from us, of these, one must become a witness with us of his resurrection." They put forward two, Joseph called Barsabbas, who was also called Justas, and Matthias. They prayed and said, "You, Lord, who know the hearts of all men, show which one of these two you have chosen to take part in this ministry and apostleship from which Judas fell away, that he might go to his own place." They drew lots for them, and the lot fell on Matthias, and he was counted with the 11 apostles. Think about it. Pause this movie. Do you know someone who followed Jesus for a long time, but later turned away from him? Someone like Judas. Tongues of fire! Acts chapter 2, verses 1 to 28. Background. Jesus has risen from the dead, met with his people, and returned to heaven. Jesus told his followers to stay together and to wait for his Spirit to come to them. Now, when the day of Pentecost had come, they were all with one accord in one place. Suddenly, there came from the sky a sound like the rushing of a mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. Tongues like fire appeared and were distributed to them, and one sat on each of them. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak with other languages, as the Spirit gave them the ability to speak. Now there were dwelling in Jerusalem Jews, devout men from every nation under the sky. When this sound was heard, the multitude came together and were bewildered, because everyone heard them speaking in his own language. They were all amazed and marveled, saying to one another, "Behold, aren't all these who speak Galileans? How do we hear everyone in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and people from Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus, Asia, Phrygia, Pamphylia, Egypt, the parts of Libya around Cyrene, visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabians, We hear them speaking in our languages the mighty works of God. They were all amazed and were perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" Others, mocking, said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing up with the 11, lifted up his voice and spoke out to them, "You men of Judea, and all you who dwell at Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to my words. For these aren't drunken, as you suppose, seeing it is only the third hour of the day. But this is what has been spoken through the prophet Joel. It will be in the last days, says God, that I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams. Yes, and on my servants and on my handmaidens in those days, I will pour out my spirit, and they will prophesy. I will show wonders in the sky above and signs on the earth beneath, blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the great and glorious day of the Lord comes. It will be that whoever will call on the name of the Lord will be saved. Men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved by God to you by mighty works and wonders and signs, which God did by him amongst you, even as you yourselves know. Him, being delivered up by the determined counsel and foreknowledge of God, you have taken by the hand of lawless men, crucified and killed, whom God raised up, having freed him from the agony of death, because it was not possible that he should be held by it. For David says concerning him, 'I saw the Lord always before my face, for he's on my right hand, that I should not be moved. Therefore, my heart was glad, and my tongue rejoiced. Moreover, my flesh also will dwell in hope, because you will not leave my soul in Hades, neither will you allow your Holy One to see decay. You made known to me the ways of life. You will make me full of gladness with your presence.' Think about it. Have you called out to the Lord to save you? Have you asked His Holy Spirit to come into you? Tell us your story. 3,000 saved. Background. The loud sound of God's Holy Spirit was rushing into the house where the believers were praying. Thousands came running to see what was happening. Peter stood up to preach the gospel. Go, Peter! Peter begins with a story about King David. Brothers, I may tell you freely of the patriarch David, that he both died and was buried, and his tomb is with us to this day. Therefore, being a prophet, and knowing that God had sworn with an oath to him, that of the fruit of his body according to the flesh, he would raise up the Christ to sit on his throne. And he, David, foreseeing this, spoke about the resurrection of the Christ, that his soul wasn't left in Hades, and his flesh didn't see decay. This Jesus God raised up, to which we all are witnesses. Being therefore exalted by the right hand of God, and having received from the Father the promise of the Holy Spirit, he has poured out this, which you now see and hear. For David didn't ascend into the heavens, but he says himself, 'The Lord said to my Lord, sit by my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet.' Let all the house of Israel therefore know certainly that God has made him both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified. Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and the rest of the apostles, 'Brothers, what shall we do?' Peter said to them, 'Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of sins. And you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is to you, and to your children, and to all who are far off, even as many as the Lord our God will call to himself. With many other words he testified and exhorted them, saying, Save yourselves from this crooked generation. Then those who gladly received his word were baptized. There were added that day about 3,000 souls. They continued steadfastly in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and prayer. Fear came on every soul, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They sold their possessions and goods and distributed them to all, according as anyone had need. Day by day, continuing steadfastly with one accord in the temple and breaking bread at home, they took their food with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God and having favor with all the people. The Lord added to the assembly day by day those who were being saved. Think about it. Peter told the people to repent and be baptized so their sins could be forgiven. Have you turned away from your sins and been baptized? Get up and walk. Acts chapter 3, verses 1 to 26. Background. A 38-year-old crippled man is brought to the temple every day to beg for money. He's been crippled every day of his life. Until Peter and John step into the scene. Peter and John were going up into the temple at the hour of prayer, the ninth hour. A certain man who was lame from his mother's womb was being carried, whom they laid daily at the door of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask gifts for the needy of those who entered into the temple. Seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked to receive gifts for the needy. Peter, fastening his eyes on him with John, said, Look at us! He listened to them, expecting to receive something from them. But Peter said, I have no silver or gold, but what I have, that I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, get up and walk. He took him by the right hand and raised him up. Immediately, his feet and his ankle bones received strength. Leaping up, he stood and began to walk. He entered with them into the temple, walking, leaping, and praising God. All the people saw him walking and praising God. They recognized him, that it was he who used to sit begging for gifts for the needy at the beautiful gate of the temple. They were filled with wonder and amazement at what had happened to him. As the lame man, who was healed, held on to Peter and John, all the people ran together to them in the porch that is called Solomon's, greatly wondering. When Peter saw it, he responded to the people, You men of Israel, why do you marvel at this man? Why do you fasten your eyes on us? As though by our own power or godliness we had made him walk. The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you delivered up and denied in the presence of Pilate when he had determined to release him. But you denied the Holy and Righteous One and asked for a murderer to be granted to you and killed the Prince of Life, whom God raised from the dead, to which we are witnesses. By faith in his name has made this man strong, whom you see and know. Yes, the faith which is through him, has given him this perfect soundness in the presence of you all. Now, brothers, I know that you did this in ignorance, as did also your rulers. But the things which God announced by the mouth of all his prophets, that Christ should suffer, he thus fulfilled. Repent, therefore, and turn again, that your sins may be blotted out, so that there may come times of refreshing from the presence of the Lord, and that he may send Christ Jesus, who was ordained for you before, whom heaven must receive until the times of restoration of all things, which God spoke long ago by the mouth of his holy prophets. For Moses indeed said to the fathers, The Lord God will raise up a prophet for you from amongst your brothers like me. You shall listen to him in all things, whatever he says to you. It will be that every soul that will not listen to that prophet will be utterly destroyed from amongst the people. Yes, and all the prophets from Samuel and those who followed after, as many as have spoken, they also told of these days. You are the children of the prophets and of the covenant which God made with our fathers, saying to Abraham, All the families of the earth will be blessed through your offspring. God, having raised up his servant Jesus, sent him to you first to bless you, in turning away every one of you from your wickedness. Think about it. Pause this movie and talk about it. Peter reminds the people that the Old Testament prophets predicted the coming of Jesus many years before he came. Are you ready to read the Old Testament for yourself? Thrown into jail. Acts chapter 4, verses 1 to 12. Background. Thousands of people believe in Jesus after they see the miracle of the languages and hear the gospel good news from Peter. But now, Peter and John are in trouble. As they spoke to the people, the priests and the captain of the temple and the Sadducees came to them, being upset because they taught the people and proclaimed in Jesus the resurrection from the dead. They laid hands on them and put them in custody until the next day, for it was now evening. But many of those who heard the word believed, and the number of the men came to be about 5,000. In the morning, their rulers, elders, and scribes were gathered together in Jerusalem. Annas the high priest was there with Caiaphas, John, Alexander, and as many as were relatives of the high priest. When they had stood Peter and John in the middle of them, they inquired, By what power or in what name have you done this? Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, You rulers of the people and elders of Israel, if we are examined today concerning a good deed done to a crippled man, by what means this man has been healed? May it be known to you all, and to all the people of Israel, that in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, this man stands here before you whole in him. He is the stone which was regarded as worthless by you, the builders, which has become the head of the corner. There is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven that is given amongst men by which we must be saved. Keep reading Acts, Peter's miraculous escape. Paul meets Jesus on the road. And Paul's miraculous shipwreck. Continue reading all of our verse-by-verse Bibles, including our Book of Acts series, at mrmacbible.com.